Hey everybody, I'm Scott.
I'm Stephanie.
And welcome back, and this is...
Can You Play As a Girl?
Where we talk about video games. Stephanie is a big gamer, and I'm really not, and she has some very intense opinions about the games that she plays. So she has no idea that what game I'm going to ask her about, so this is live and unscripted, and we get her honest feedback. And it gives us an excuse to drink. And talk about video games.
Cheers.
Cheers.
I also want to say, I wouldn't say that I have intense opinions on video games.
You have strong opinions.
I have strong opinions. I'm not going to come out here like...
How is that again? Thank you. So we're going to talk about Little Dragon Cafe.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So what is Little Dragon Cafe?
Little Dragon Cafe is a game that I would say is for all ages. It's part cafe simulator and part like exploring a world kind of thing. You play as either you can play it as a girl,
okay,
a boy or a girl.
Okay, good to know.
And your mom has fallen ill, and somehow this relates to you getting a dragon. Like, you need a dragon to help your mom get better.
Okay.
I don't know. All right. Explain it not well. It's a thing.
Okay. You need a dragon because mom's sick.
Yes.
Check.
So all right. You get a dragon and you help it grow. And you run this cafe while mom's sick. And all these, like, little colorful characters come in and you have to help them. There's, like, a ghost. There is a cat singer idol.
Okay.
There's a witch. There's just different people who come in and you have to help them somehow, always by making them some kind of food.
Because food makes everything better.
Yes.
Okay.
You have to go around on your dragon and collect ingredients every day.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So you play as a girl, so that's good. Is there a romance in Little Dragon Cafe?
No.
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 No. Just not going that way. Okay. So what do you like about Little Dragon Cafe?
I like the art style. I like that it's cute. I like that it's pretty low stress. Like, if you need something that isn't going to be super dramatic, there's not any, like,
just
difficult...
like fun and silly.
Yeah.
And,
okay. There's no, like, moral choices, gray moral choices you have to make. It's just fun and silly. Like I said, it's for all ages. Like, you know, a 9-year-old could play this game and it'd be totally fun.
Okay, so very mellow. So what do you not like about Little Dragon Cafe?
What I don't like about it is the gathering gets pretty tedious.
Resource gathering, like going to get materials and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a lot of times in resource gathering kinds of games, like farming games, after a while you get some kind of automated system that helps you because, like, the demand is greater, and so you get, you know, like sprinklers or whatever for your farm, and there's nothing like that in Little Dragon Cafe.
You just have to grind it out.
You just have to grind it out. Whoa. And it gets tedious and it gets really challenging when you have, like, when you start the game, you have like 3 customers, and I'm about 2/3 of the way through it, and I have like 20 customers every mealtime.
And everybody wants something different.
And they want something different, and if you run out of ingredients, they get huffy and they leave. And I'm like, I'm literally going out for flour every day, dude. Like, I can't keep up with the demand. I don't know what you want from me.
Can you, like, hire extra staff?
No. And your staff, like, slacks off. I guess that's, like, the cafe simulator part of it. But your staff, like, slack off, and you have to, like, go back from gathering ingredients to yell at them and make sure that they're doing what they need to do.
Okay.
Yeah. Wow. So it's just, it gets a little bit tedious that way. I wish that there was some way to help scale getting ingredients.
Or get some helpers or something.
Yeah, something. Because it does start to become a little bit stressful at that point.
So who should play Little Dragon Cafe?
You know, Little Dragon Cafe is one of those games that I could play when something really intense is going on in my life, and I just need a game where, like, nothing bad is ever gonna happen. You know, like, when my cat passed away a few years ago, I just played Story of Seasons for, like, 3 weeks straight. And it's just a game where you can count on like nothing bad ever happening. Like the characters are all friendly and nice. It's like a cheerful kind of tone. So it's something that you can play like if you just need something neutral and cheerful.
And light and easy.
Yeah.
So will you play it again? Will you finish it?
I'm trying to finish it. Like I said, I'm 2/3 of the way through. Oh, another thing that kind of irritates me is I looked up and apparently, so there's 12 chapters in the game. Your dragon grows to its full size at the end of the 12th chapter.
Of course, of course.
So, like, you don't even get to, like, enjoy having your dragon be able to go anywhere it wants. Because, like, the bigger your dragon is, the more you can fly around the island, like, the higher you can go, the more places you can go to. And, like, I guess maybe there's some post-game content or something.
So you don't even get to enjoy, like, full dragon power until the very end.
No, my dragon's still a teenager. I'm disappointed.
So you're going to finish it? You're going to try to come back and finish it?
I am going to try and finish it. I think it's doable. I just have to just grind it out to finish it.
But you can kind of pick it up and put it down. You're kind of bouncing around back and forth with it.
Yeah. It's not, like, super complicated to come back to.
We have to, like, relearn it every time.
Yeah, it's okay.
And you can just put it down and pick it back up. Mm-hmm. Okay. So who should play it? Who should play Little Dragon Cafe?
It is a game for all ages, although something that I was telling a friend the other day is when I say it's for all ages, like, sometimes I kind of feel like a little kid playing it. It is... kind of feels like a little kid game sometimes. But there's some games that, like, you know, like a Miyazaki movie, you can watch it and like a little kid could really appreciate it and a grown-up can also really appreciate it and really enjoy it. And Little Dragon Cafe kind of feels like watching Sesame Street sometimes. I don't know what it is about it. It just kind of feels like a little kid game. So if you're a little kid, it's a good game.
Or you want something at that like stress level, like yeah. Let's just make this slow and easy and just keep this mellow.
Yeah. It's a good game for kids. It's also a good game if you just want something you can turn your brain off. Like you can just
don't have to think real
coast
hard.
On it.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you're like feeling stressed out, it's not a game that's gonna add to your stress. And the characters are actually pretty cute. I do appreciate the characters. They keep me engaged in the game and wanting to move forward with it.
Okay, final thoughts on Little Dragon Cafe.
It's listed for $60 on Switch and it goes on sale semi-frequently for like $16, so I would wait for a sale.
$60 to $16, yeah, I'll wait for a sale.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it's going to be a pretty big time sink, I have to say. Like, I'm probably right around 30 hours right now, and I think I still have, you know, 10 to 20 to go.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So it'll take up some time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. Okay. All right. Thanks, everybody. If you enjoyed this, please give us a like and a subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one. Bye.
Thanks, y'all. Bye.